Memorial Day Cook 2016. Hanging out at the Barbecue Superstar television set. Cooking up a whole lot of barbecue. Brisket, ribs, hamburgers. The day before, I did a 1 hour hamburger show. Really came out good. Royal Arc Charcoal, the number one charcoal, best in the land. Of course, Royal Oak. Now, folks, this brisket turned out fabulous. It was one of the best briskets I ever did. And Quick Trim was great in trimming the brisket. Stay tuned, we're going to have us a good time.
Got some paper towels and a little bit of cardboard from the egg grate up under there. Uh-oh. I might have got these wet. If I can catch that paper towel on fire, I won't take it but one match. These chimneys really work good, and there's no way you'll get lighter fluid in the flavor. I don't have to pay 99 cents for something I'll use about 5 times and I have to go buy it again. It's probably more expensive than that now, you know how that goes. Happy Memorial Day. Let's see how our Royal Oak does. This is live action now. I'm not rigging or anything. I'm not doing anything. That's egg crate, paper towels, and that's Royal Oak. Got the cookers completely full, so all I gotta do is get this lit, pour it on top, half in one, half in the other, and we'll be ready to. I might have put too much cardboard. No, it's just, I think it's gonna go. Get our brisket. We'll start off with brisket. There it goes. The star of the show this morning is Quick Trim. Notice it's got that piece of plastic on it. That thing is sharp, sharp, sharp. Yeah, it's gone. One match. Just a few minutes. Okay, let's let it go ahead and burn for just a little bit. We'll come back and put it in the smoker in about 5 minutes. Quick trim. Quick trim is a new device. It's got the knife blade turned, so it's knife blade turned so you don't have to turn your hand. That's one thing I didn't even realize, is how much you turn in your hand when you use a knife. You got a restaurant and you do a lot of brisket, this quick trim is the way to go. I don't sell them. KWIK Quick Trim. TRIM. Look at that daggone roll of oak taking off. I might not put these on yet. I might. Let's just wait a second. We'll dump it. Problem is, I gotta do two instead of one. So I gotta let it get pretty well going toward the top before I dump it, so I can have enough to start two cans up. I got a camera over there. I don't have to show it to you guys. I put it on the recorded. I did a monster. I did a monster show yesterday with hamburgers. It's on the cooking channel. Best hamburgers in the world. Boy, they was good. Really worked out. Really good. It's Memorial Day. It's time to get out there and have a good time. Remember the troops. Fought in all the wars. Keep the country free. Freedom isn't free. Let's see if we can get our brisket open here. It says XL on it, but this is really a JBS brisket. JBS is a Brazilian meat company that's come up here and bought Swift Premium. And it's like I was telling somebody, Swift Premium's got just as good a stuff as anybody. They're just being out talked. Here we go. Oh god, yeah. I gotta learn how to use it. QWIKTRIM. Look at there. Oh god. Uh oh. Whoa, we'll be able to skim this stuff off of here without taking all the meat off of it. Oh my goodness. Oh, I'm sold on this. Let me go ahead and put that in the smoker right quick. Before it gets out of hand over here. Thank you.
good.
Yeah, we got it all together. Got our cookers ready. This is very intriguing. Now the biggest problem with brisket has been trying to get this thing silver skin off the top of it right here. And look, that just solved the problem. Let's see, I just wonder if it's sharp enough. Yeah, it is. Could get a paper towel, clean it off. See, I've got an edge right there. That's, look at there. Shoot, I don't have to fight the knife to get this. Oh shit, look at this. Well, there just went all the work. Whoop, I got too deep on that one. That was my fault. Holy shit. Look at that clean piece of right across there. Look how clean that came. Shoot, let's see if we can. Whoa. If that don't make it easy. Whoa, Quick Trim, KWIKTRIM. Whoa. Crazy cool. Now, fat. Ain't no problem. Man, this thing is cool. There you go. Look at there. I'm going to skin this right off the top of this meat. Wow, Quick Trim. By turning the knife, you put pressure on your wrist. You can't, it's hard to control. This thing here takes that all away. Hell yeah, that thing's good. Okay, so here's the flat, and there's the break. There's the fat in between wow, look at there. Ain't gotta worry about gouging nothing. Got like a flat surface though.
Wow, I mean, I haven't wasted hardly nothing.
And I don't have a dug up
front, you know, where there's a bunch of digs in it. Quick Trim. Holy camoly. All right. Let's turn it over and see what the fat cap's going to do. Man, look at there. I mean, that came right off the front. Didn't have to fight it. Just came right off. Thin that fat cap down. Let's see how we can do with that. Don't want to get too deep. Look at there.
get some of it off. Fat cap's the hardest thing to ain't getting paid nothing now. He sent me one and I'm trying it out. That's all that's going on here. AWIKTRIM. Good God Almighty, look at that. See how this thing does on a Boston butt. The only reason I'm skimming over like I am is I'm trying to keep from getting in the meat. Now every ounce of this I take off the back will make it cook faster. Got a little pop from two crackers cooking. He just got his case knife out and did it. I'm able to control it and keep it from digging in the meat. But because of my hand angle, I'm able to get close without getting into it. Some of you probably out there saying, oh, if you can handle a knife good enough, you don't need that. Well, if you're a caterer or a vendor and you got to do a bunch of these every day, this will speed your process up. Save your wrist. Shoot, I like it. Damn. Ain't good enough with it yet. Look at that. Direction. Only reason I'm doing fat cap and all is because I want to see how good it works. It's like you're raking it. Sort of reminds me of a meat rake and the way it's built. I think meat rakes handles, I like them. They're good, man. They're good. There you go, that's how you use it. pounds of the meat on the back side of it pretty damn quick. I essentially took all the fat off them, which means it's going to cook a lot faster, so I got to be watching that about my cook times. This is a little brisket. Damn. I don't know that I've ever trimmed one this lean before. Shoot, it ain't got no fat on it at all, except for I left some in here. That's a steak. That's a brisket steak now. Well, hey, what do you think? I don't know. What do you think? I think it did a fantastic job. I also think I better wash it and put that cap on it. It'll cut my hand. Thing right there is razor sharp. Well, happy Labor Day. I mean, happy Memorial Day. We up here rock and rolling. Find the plastic piece that goes on it. There it is. I think this is one of your number one concerns. If you buy one, you got to keep it like that when you store it. Don't let it sit out with that blade out there. The kid will have it and cut his hand off. Alright, so we're going to build us an injection this morning. I decided this morning, first thing we're going to do is do a beef condensed soup. Now, if you're on the competition trail, they say it'll leave marks and because there's caramel color in it. Competing in KCBS, it don't matter if you got caramel colors or not, they're gonna rig it anyway, so that'll give them something to look point at and say they you didn't do that good, because they're gonna screw you anyway. But we're doing backyard, so this stuff tastes good. This stuff really adds to Butcher's premium beef injection. Now they got the prime injection, which everybody's crazy over that, so I've always used the original injection. Boy, look at that beef flavor. That's what beef injection's all about. Beef, beef, more beef, beef flavor. You can't get any beef broth that's that good. It won't be nowhere near that dark. It ain't even like how many ounces is a ten and a half ounces. Okay, so we're gonna finish it off a little Mott's. Mott's isn't the best. Mott's is just another one. Get your favorite apple juice and use it. Okay, we're gonna get us some Butcher Original. Put half a cup in it. Some of that'll go down as you mix it. Now that is something. Now you got something. That apple juice will help soften that brisket up. Really, if you know you're gonna do a brisket the night before, it's probably better just to go ahead and mix it up the night before. Some people put cooking oil in it to make it thicker. Going with the grain, mostly going against the grain. Some people like it, some people don't. I went ahead and brought the big bore needle in here. Let's get in this point now, bottom part of the front. Oop. kind of hate to fold it up because you put pressure on the brisket, but I can't get nothing in that point if I don't. Butcher just makes it taste good, that's all. Look at that. Whoop. I don't ever want to wipe that extra rub off, injection off. Just leave it on there. I'll rub it off. That's that much flavor. More flavor might get into it. Okay. So we're going to start it off with our Butcher premium rub. But the only reason is because I'm going to use this deep tissue massage from, and once I put that on, that's going to be the end of it, because that's the best stuff in the whole world, and I don't want anything to go over top of that. Put a little Butcher premium on here to get it started. It's very much worthwhile turning it over this time. Let me get that head before I do it. Get these burnt ends good because they're a source of a lot of flavor. It's not going to take very long to cook this thing. 4 or 5 hours at the most, probably. Okay. I brought out Big T seasoning salt. That's going to be the next one. Here it is. This ain't never been pulled out before. I'm gonna go ahead and try it on this brisket. Get some of that good Texas flavor. I decided to go ahead and put him on out there. Ooh, look at there. Big T seasoning salt. Yeah, I think before I turn it over, I'm going to go ahead and put the deep tissue massage on it. Now, I've never used this on the air before. This is the joint on brisket. This is the end all and the do all. This is where your Texas comes in. I ate this one time on a brisket, and man, it was so good. Once we put this on there, we ain't gonna put nothing else on there. I forgot to put mother rubs on this. Alright, let's turn it over. Turn it over one time. Okay, let's go ahead and get our seasoning salt on there, because all I got on it right now is Butcher's. Seasoning salt one time. Put after this one, we're gonna do a rack of ribs. Quick trim. I believe it did the deal. Around this edge right here. Oh, it's sucking up them flavors, man. That's a highly flavorized brisket right there. Give it a few minutes to suck up them flavors. I'm gonna take a few pictures. Big T Caesar salt. Big T deep tissue massage. Smelling good, tasting good. Got the brisket out and I got down with it. What? I got down with it. You know how you know if somebody doesn't know how to cook? I mean, like big time championship cook. When they stand around there and say that they've never injected any meat. And I think most of you probably know who I'm talking about. Got a big mouth, got his face stuck everywhere, and he don't even inject his meat. Took 40th in every contest, went to Artesia, New Mexico, and won the first one. Yeah, man, I believe that. Boy, look at that brisket. Let's get close up on here just for a second. Run it down it. Got pictures of him walking up in places like it's a big deal because he walked up in it. You know, well, his legs ain't broke, at least not yet. Look, folks, you cannot season a brisket any better than that. That's the max. Thank you. fire kick up a little bit, get going. A little bit better this morning. All right, let's get over here and get a rack of ribs. It's Memorial Day, man. We're gonna cook it up today. I did that big hamburger cook yesterday. Made an hour video, but I had to essentially build it in three pieces. All right, for all you cross-contamination people, I'm gonna change gloves right quick. The mighty Smithfields today. Okay, now we're going to inject these ribs with Butcher's new pork injection. Buy it right now, Barbecue Superstar. I'm gonna put a little, I put apple juice in it, but I'm gonna put a little mango nectar in it. Actually, that's all I meant to put in there, but. Yeah, mango nectar is good too. All right, there's our butcher pork injection. Mango nectar and apple juice. All right, let's get down here on the ribs. Can't go Memorial Day weekend without cooking some ribs, man. Smithfield extra tender. How can they assign that name to these ribs? Change gloves before I get down on these things. Plus, I blew one of them out, so. Biggest thing you gotta remember is take the membrane off the back. Silver skin, membrane. I don't know what they're calling it. You can take some of the silver skin off this top part too for your riblets. We're gonna cook them too. That's why I always get spare ribs, so we got riblets too. Nobody wants to eat them, we'll give them to Molly. Sometimes they come out just as good as a regular premium rib do. So what we're gonna be doing is a St. Louis cut. We went to St. Louis and we cut it. Here you go, start up here, this top edge. That's the easiest one to get under. This is how the Chinese manufacture ribs. Dang, that came off easy. Now let's see. Okay, this piece has already been removed. Yep. Well. Alright, now come down the center part right here. Oh, they're short. They cut them short here. Shoot, yeah, they cut them real short. Okay. Yeah, Smithfield. They're gonna give you half of them, keep half of them. Chinese action. I like the Chinese. They'll work for 10 cents an hour. Problem is, the people that they're working for done got rich. Okay, here's our riblets. A piece of tinfoil to lay them on. People are working for getting rich. Let's see. Well, that's a little bit normal, more normal size rib. That's a tiny little bitty rib. I guess I'll even it up, but I hate to have these little 3-inch ribs. I don't like it. I remember one time I was at a contest, and here come this guy down through there, and he said, "We're getting ready to do some bullshit." He was so funny. I keep bringing that up, but he was cool, man. Okay. See if I can get in between these ribs now. The only problem is I got the big bore needle. Whoop. I need that little one. I might have to go get it. There we go. Oh, that's doing good. You won't believe how much difference this makes. Just got a little bit of meat there, and that injection does such a job on it when you infuse it into those ribs. Got too high on it. Got to get right down the center of it. Right down the center from top to bottom. Well, you got to use a small bore needle, what you got to do. There's they're short enough. I got all the way over on it. Shoot, yeah. Let's try it this way. The only problem is I might let some out of it. We'll get a higher. Whoop. How about that shit? Yep. Okay, so we're gonna get us some Big T swine grind. I'm gonna go ahead and use one of my good ones. Just cause it's so good, I wanna eat it. And that's our base coat for all our pork now. Big T swine grind. Big T swine grind. And these things are thin. Get a little bit of this Suckle Buster Texas pecan. I got to get some more of his flavors. This just happens to be the only one I have in house. But this son of a gun sure is good. Some people will roll it up on the edge. Whip it this time. Do the back just like you do the front. The edge right there is just as important as any part of it. Okay. Now let's go on back on top with a little swine grind. Texas pecan. Make sure the top will load it down. Alright, let's run these ribs over here. Happy Memorial Day. It's a great day to celebrate the troops. Our smoker builder Iron Man cooker is rolling. what I'm talking about. That's what Memorial Day is all about right there. I'm gonna leave it open and get it cranking a little bit. It rained awful hard last night. Well, we got our riblets to do. Alright. I'm just gonna leave that juice down there. It came out of the same rack of ribs. It all in one piece. If we get it tender enough, we'll be able to pull it apart anyway. Okay, we're gonna put our swine grind on it. Big T swine grind. Ribs are really cheap. I got these for $9. Yeah, let's put us a little. So you don't. A little Texas pecan, sucker buster Texas pecan. And we'll go a little premium rub. That's what we're trying to do with making them fall apart and done. We got one more grater we're gonna put to it. Okay, gonna have to double it, but put a riblet. And here we're gonna put us a half a stick of butter in it. Loosen it up a little bit. We're gonna have that brisket on a tight rope. I'm not gonna let it go a long time before I wrap it because it's got no fat on it. We're gonna always double it because it'll leak. I wanna make sure that butter stays in there and the moisture off the riblets because they're gonna. I could have Texas crushed that, but I didn't. I don't know why I didn't. All right, let's see what time it is. 9:36, we'll be back at 11:36, 2 hours exactly. 11:36, mark your clocks. Move on to the next step. Get yourself a beer. Get ready for a great Memorial Day. Got some ribs. We got some brisket down in here. Get a pair of gloves on. Okay, we've been cooking along about an hour at 2 hours at 300 degrees. And she's awful lean. She ain't got no fat on her. I'm gonna wait and get the tinfoil out here in a second when I see for sure whether she's got enough on it to wrap or not. As lean as it is, I'm sure it is, but I wanna check it first. Boom, let's see. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, yes. Shrunk up quite a bit. It's got a lot of liquid on top. That's when you can tell if you need to wrap it and have liquid on top. I don't think I want to get it burnt any more than it is. It's not burnt at all right now. It's got some beautiful crust on it. Okay, it's rolling now. So. I'm gonna get some tinfoil over here. Me some more meat rakes. I left one somewhere. I got one, but I left one. I gotta order some more, so I'm gonna pick it up with this big spatula. That's definitely a Kodak moment right there. Sun's so bright out here today that I took the rubs and put them in there on the table right quick because I'm scared it's going to cook them. Shoot, rubs will cook in this direct sunlight. Got to keep them in the shade so the ultraviolet can't get a hold of it. The only thing I'm really interested in putting on it right now is deep tissue massage.
Feels cheap.
You really don't have to put much. That's probably too much. Get some on the tinfoil around, it's important. Okay. Piece on top, two pieces on top, roll it up, roll it up. For me, I'm gonna put my injection in there. I'm out too salty. Put just a little bit of apple juice. And then the main ingredient when you're out, you gotta put that agave nectar. If you don't put that on there, just ain't gonna do the deal like it's supposed to. This is a very important step right here. Put a half a jar in it. It's not just a sweetener, it does something to the meat I can't explain. It sure is good. Okay, now we're gonna cook until it gets soft. Come back over here and smoke it. Every time I take the lid off, leave it off on my drum smoker, it'll get hotter. Have to watch it, it'll get too hot and burn your meat up. And that lean as that is, that thing will burn up easy. Okay. Let's bring you over here to this one now. Check out our rack of ribs. Check out our rack of ribs. Oh yeah, wow, look at there. Boy, don't that look good. How about that? Shoot. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. What kind of picture we got of it? On the camera right here. Wow, that came out good. Hours, 300 degrees. That song gun's getting right. That really worked out good. Okay. Pull it around here. Get on the ribs. I'm not going to brown sugar them today. I'm going to put butter in them. Man, the daggone sun is bright. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to put some butcher premium on it. Put some agave nectar on it, light agave nectar. Okay, I'm going to Texas pepper. Before we close them up, put just a little bit of our injection in it. Give it a little more juice, soften it up. Okay, I'm gonna put these in the cooker. Now for all you gas grillers out there, we got a little treat for you. We'll make a hamburger because it's going to be about 2 more hours before we're done in the sun with these. Probably just put it in the smoker. Now, yesterday I made this hamburger up. And what I did with it, is I put a lot of different ingredients in it. You can see the green peppers that are in it. But mushrooms, onions. You'll have to watch that video if you really want to know what all's in this hamburger. Everything's been pre-cooked before it was put in the meat. Turkey, hamburger, and sausage. Right. crank it up till it gets hot, a little bit more. Let it shut up for just a minute. I'm gonna take this rest of this hamburger and put it in the back of the refrigerator. Call Josh and see if he wants to be making a hamburger for lunch. Close your lid on a Weber or a charcoal grill or a gas grill. You let that heat reflect and it cooks twice as fast and does twice as good when you get that lid down on it. Man, I got all three cookers smoking. It ain't gonna take long for that big old hamburger to cook.
Thank you.
discovered Iron Chef yesterday. Iron Chef, we got them all on barbecue superstar. That stuff is good, man. It's gonna take a little while for this to cook. We've got turkey, sausage, and hamburger in it. Don't cook it fast, it's just regular hamburger. Takes a little while. Happy Memorial Day. Having a good day. Cooking up hamburgers, ribs, briskets. Craig on Friday, it's funny. He said, Mom, what you doing? I'm cooking breakfast. What you cooking? Pork chops, sausage, eggs, pancakes. Grits, he said, cook it up. And then she's over there and she's got a plate and he said, where's mine? Oh, I didn't cook you any, honey. What? Just eat some cereal. We ain't got no milk. We'll put some water on it. Poor Craig, man. Oh yeah, she cooking. Cook it up. We're gonna cook us a hamburger. If you're looking, you're not cooking, but I hear all that dropping. I gotta look. Wow. Man, I'm gonna eat that hamburger up. The only thing is, it's gonna make me tired. Golden State Warriors going home tonight to play the Oklahoma Thunder. Oklahoma Thunder gonna win it, I'm sure. Golden State Warriors are gonna win it, I'm sure. Then we'll be back to Cleveland and Golden State. Cleveland will win it all this time. Cleveland will win it all. He's got his guns in there. He don't need much help, just a little bit. I turned it over more than once. I broke the rules, but I didn't smash it. That's the whole deal. Never smash a hamburger. I used to always smash it. You just got rid of all the flavor. Well, that thing's cooking up. I tell you, that charbroil does a great job. Reflective heat does a great job. Man, that quick quick the daggone cheese done got warm out here. Don't get a Weber. Don't get a all them expensive names and shit. Get a Charbroil. Charbroil number one. I've been using my grill a lot. Whoa! Hamburger ready. Hamburger looking good. Happy Memorial Day. Uh-oh, we're going to have to put some of this Iron Chef on there. Now this is the one right here. Oh man, I ate some last night. Boy, that's insane. That's so good. Cooking along about 2 hours at 300 degrees. And she's awful lean. She ain't got no fat on her. I'm gonna wait and get the tinfoil out here in a second when I see for sure whether it's got enough on it to wrap or not. As lean as it is, I'm sure it is, but I want to check it first. Oh, let's see. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, yeah, it's shrunk up quite a bit. It's got a lot of liquid on top. That's when you can tell if you need to wrap it and have liquid on top. I don't think I want to get it burnt any more than it is. It's not burnt at all right now. It's got some beautiful crust on it. Okay, it's rolling there. So. I'm gonna get some tinfoil over here. I gotta order me some more meat rakes. I left one somewhere. I got one, but I left one. I gotta order some more. So I'll pick it up with this big spatula. Sun's so bright out here today that I took the rubs and put them in there on the table. Right quick, because I'm scared it's gone. cook them. Shoot, rubs will cook in this direct sunlight. Gotta keep them in the shade so that ultraviolet can't get a hold of it. The only thing I'm really interested in putting on it right now is deep tissue massage.
Big teeth.
Well, I don't have to put much. That's probably too much. Get some on the tinfoil around, that's important. Okay. One piece on top, two pieces on top, roll it up, roll it up. For me, I'm gonna put my injection in there. I'm out too salty. Shoot. Put just a little bit of apple juice. And then the main ingredient when you're out, you gotta put that agave nectar. If you don't put that on there, it just ain't gonna do the deal like it's supposed to. This is a very important step right here. Put a half a jar in it. It's not just a sweetener, it does something to the meat I can't explain. It sure is good. Okay, now we're gonna cook it till it gets soft. Okay, let's come back over here and every time I take the lid off, leave it off on the drum smoker, it'll get hotter. Have to watch it, don't get too hot and burn your meat up. That lean as that is, that thing will burn up easy. Okay. Bring it over here to this one now. Check out a hack of ribs. Check out a hack of ribs. Yeah, wow, look at there. Boy, don't that look good. How about that? Shoot. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Let's see what kind of picture we got of it. On the camera right here. Wow, that came out good.
2 hours, 300 degrees.
That song gun's getting right. That really worked out good. I'm not going to brown sugar them today. I'm going to put butter in them. Man, that daggone sun is bright. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to put some butcher premium on it. Put us some agave nectar on it, light agave nectar. Okay, then we're gonna Texas crusher. Before we close them up, put just a little bit of our injection in it. Give it a little more juice, soften it up. Okay, we'll put these in the cooker.